If I'm playing reggae, I want to go to a 3/4 delay and make it almost like a dub delay. And I want to turn, you know, the feedback all the way up to delay all the way out for at least two bars and then bring the next record.
A DJ is somebody who understands how to take whatever format there is and create something that's very unique.
So I'm looking at a bigger picture. I'm trying to tell a story and I'm trying to take you on a journey.
Sometimes you would hear DJ sets and you would almost kind of know, ah, man, you know, you went in the studio and you really kind of produced that. But I always wanted to bring that to a live experience.
You know, when you really know a piece of equipment inside out, you can start to use it in ways that can enhance what you're doing as a performer.
So in the very beginning, it was very much based on the actual mix. I was one of those early DJs that were playing on rotary dial mixers, which were great for creating very smooth mixes.
That style of DJing, which was very smooth and different to today's style, Pioneer played a big part in that, because then suddenly we were on a crossfade or sliders.
The DJ M500 for me was the ultimate tool to add a lot more creativity to my sets with the funky flange and the amazing reverb, and it was like, wow.
I can incorporate all of my techniques into that mixer. The effects were very, very important because it then created an additional level, an additional layer to my performances, creating these echoes and delays that then allowed me to transition from one track to another.
When I first started DJing, it was all about the seamless flow of music and taking people on a journey. And the great thing about the Pioneer equipment, especially with the EFX stuff, that enables you to be a performer as well.
I remember actually playing a couple of shows where they wouldn't have the DJ M500 on the rider in the booth. They would combine it instead with the EFX 500.
You had a little dial that allowed you to dial in certain effects and to kind of change the parameters of the flanges or the filters.
This is a Blue EFX 500. It's the only one in the world, as far as I know. An Australian DJ called Phil K, he used it in a totally different way to anyone I'd ever seen. And he was like, this thing, it's a sampler. You can use it like a sampler. He showed me this thing that he did. It was basically just a feedback loop with the echo. But because it was all timed, you could chop it up and do these crazy sort of manipulations, I guess. There's a white one somewhere, I don't know who's got that.
Then after, I think, came the DJ M600. Basically, whenever a DJ M evolved, there were added effects.
Let's say I wanted a filter effect. Initially, you had to buy an external filter and put it on. Pioneer would then start saying, okay, let's incorporate that into the product.
And this was very cool. I remember the days where we would do delays by hand. And now you, with just a press of a button, you can do the same effects.
I have always been someone that has been on the quest for the perfect gear. I want the perfect turntable, I want the perfect CD, I want the perfect mixer.
As long as your mixer had two upfaders, a crossfader, two turntables, then that was the level playing field for everybody. But Pioneer, with ourselves, had a much more ambitious idea.
The key thing that came from this development relationship was the fact that these effects were manipulated by the upfaders or the crossfader. And I think that remains a unique thing with that mixer.
The ability to add effects while you're DJing took your DJ brain and actually added as a producer. I think that was almost one of the first tools that brought those two worlds together.
When we were first messing with it, we were all sort of in awe of the whole touch screen, and then gradually you realize there's so much other stuff that you can attribute to the rest of the mixer. To actually have a thing that would play like a musical scale and a sawtooth sine wave and a square wave, it was like, wow.
I went through a period that people thought that I was playing pre-recorded music because it almost sounded too professional. Like, how does he have these effects? And how is he controlling these effects on top of all of the other stuff that he's doing? You know, it's almost like as soon as you say, you know what, Pioneer should make a mixer that does, it comes out. It's kind of like, okay, I'm just gonna shut up now.
In 2004, I think I was the first North American DJ to road test the DVJ. It was just an opportunity to demonstrate something completely new to people.
Pioneer released a press release saying, we're working on the world's first DVD player, which you could pitch and manipulate. I was on the phone with them, you know, a second later and said, okay, you know, we need to hook up because I want to be a part of this. So I worked with a video producer or various video producers who helped me sculpt my DJ sets.
I think the first thing everybody thought of was taking all their old VHS videos and being able to scratch them on a DVJ.
I did about 2 years of these audiovisual residencies where I would, you know, come in with the SVM and DJ in this environment and bring image to the room. When it happened, there were some real magical moments going on. Like, we all felt like we were doing something that sort of was pushing the elements.
The RMX is a different beast, actually, altogether. You know, there are things on there that are new, and there are things that are still from the EFX and the 500 and the 1000.
I remember seeing this box for the first time, and it instantly took me back to the late 90s, where I got very much influenced by Jeff Mills, who would always bring his TR-909 drum computer to his shows, and on the fly would program like new drum patterns and do like an actual live thing.
I remember the original idea for the RMX was they were going to do modules and stick them together, and in the end everything ended up going in one unit. I think I've got a napkin somewhere with like little drawings on, like the, you know, the original concept.
I was addicted to the vinyl break switch, and it's funny, you can even hear it in the music that was from that era. For instance, in the Avicii Levels would have that kind of vinyl break in the melody even.
The great thing about the RMX is you can switch it on, play with it, and you get a result straight away. That's the kind of thing I like about these effects units. It's using them in ways that other people, it's not that they're not supposed to be used in that way, but just ways that aren't sort of instant.
I first started using the 900 a couple of years ago.
My personal favorite is the spiral effect. A friend of mine was just over at my house. He kept just turning it on, like, just as we were playing through records, and he's just like, it instantly makes records sound better. I like being able to kind of have multiple layers of effects, and you can get some cool combinations that way. You know, now it's pretty much the standard. You walk into any club, it's already there.
I am a turntable user, and I probably would use a turntable until I can't use a turntable. I still use CDs, I have the controllers, I use all of that. You know, that's how I was brought up. It's like a guitar player playing a Gibson. I'm gonna play a Gibson until Gibson doesn't make Gibsons anymore.
Even though I'm using CD turntables for the purposes of what I'm doing right now, I still think about it in terms of, you know, two decks.
The key always is to let the record play and then mess with it. So people hear the record, but then they can understand because they can see you moving your hands about. But they can also hear the same elements being played in a different way.
It almost raises the bar for the audience that now the audience kind of really like to hear a really complete idea.
As an artist, I didn't want to kind of like be that kind of dexterous. So I just wanted to be able to people to see that I've been a little bit more creative than I would be just by mixing one record from one into another. It's all what I do as a human. It's what I like to give to people, to show that you have all this technology, but behind it all, there's still a human running it all.
Honestly, Pioneer's impact in the industry has been huge.
They're paying attention to the needs of all DJs. You know, here's the scratch DJs, here's the turntablers, here are the club DJs, here's the DJs that use controllers. You know, I think it's amazing to just have one company that kind of has so many different holds on so many different styles of DJing.
It seems to me that they want to work alongside the DJ and work with him rather than trying to dictate this is where we're going and this is what we're doing. I think that's why all the DJs you ask are here doing it, because we do respect Pioneer.